steer so clear of this. I should have returned this. I just never did. Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. I am back. It has been quite some time since I have uploaded here to my channel. It's been almost a month. Some of you were caught up to speed as to why I have not been posting here. Check out the community tab if you haven't already. I kind of give you a glimpse into what's been going on, where I've been, and why I haven't been posting. I will touch on that a little bit towards the end of this video. So if you're interested in hearing about that, we'll talk about it after we go through all of these products. Now, I have tried a ton of new makeup over the past couple of months or so that I just haven't had a chance to talk about here on my channel. So we're going to go over this stuff today. I have some incredible products to share with you, like products that I have become obsessed with and can't stop using like every single time I'm doing my makeup. But there are also some major fails, like some of these products are complete shit that I'm about to share with you. And one in particular just really disappointed me. I had such high hopes for. So let's dive into it. I'm gonna mix it all up here. We'll have some of the good, some of the bad, and we'll just kind of dive in and cover all of these products. Let's start with the eyeshadow palettes. So I've tried quite a few eyeshadow palettes. The first one I wanna talk about is the Too Faced Teddy Bear palette. I was drawn into this solely for the packaging. Now, some of you may know, I am a huge fan of Too Faced eyeshadows. For me, they just work well. Their gingerbread spice palettes, the pumpkin spice palette, the chocolate bar palettes, I absolutely love them. I feel like they are just solid, good quality, very consistent formula. I absolutely love them. This palette, however, shocked me a bit. First off, the size. When I saw promos for this palette, I pictured something much larger. When I got it in the mail, I thought I had ordered something from like Wish or something. I was like, did I get the knockoff? Is it really this small? Like, I really actually thought that I had a knockoff product. And I did a little bit of digging and I was like, nope, it's actually this tiny. Packaging is still absolutely adorable. We've got some pretty neutrals in here. I mean, it kind of goes along with the theme of the palette, bear, teddy bear. But I do have to say, the formula is not my favorite. Now, the mattes in here are really nice, blend beautifully, very pigmented. I didn't have any issues with them at all, but the metallics just fell kind of short for me. I expected them to have much more payoff. They just did not give me the punch that I was hoping for. Just did not live up to the other Too Faced palettes that I have quality-wise. Overall, I would say you could save your money. I would not be running to get this by any means. There are definitely much better palettes from Too Faced. Let's move on to the next palettes. Now, this is a fun one. Hip Dot, which is a brand that I had never really tried before. I got one of their palettes in a BoxyCharm a couple months ago or so. I was super impressed with the formula when I was swatching it, but I never tried it. Who knows why? I have way too much makeup. I saw that they had collaborated with Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, and I thought that this was absolutely adorable. So I ordered the two palettes and I also ordered the two tinted balms as well. Now, the star of the show are these palettes. These are incredible and they smell like Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. I mean, smells so much like peanut butter. When I was testing these out and doing my makeup with these, I kept thinking I had like a peanut butter cup somewhere hidden or stashed, melting in my room somewhere. But no, it was just the palette. It smells delicious. It makes you want to eat it. This is the, what is this one? This is the Peanut Butter White Chocolate palette. This one is my favorite of the two. I'll show you this one in just a moment. The formula is next level. So good. Totally blew me away. I mean, these mattes, they are so buttery smooth. They blended like a dream. The metallics in here are absolutely lovely, pack a punch. Didn't even have to wet my brush. There is a pressed glitter in each palette, but to be honest with you, not really into glitter. I rarely put glitter on my eyes, but it is a very pretty glitter. If you are wanting something a little bit more compact, a little bit more neutral with a pop of color, like this orange shade right here, you would love this palette. Love the size, super good. This is the Milk Chocolate palette. This one is gorgeous as well. I absolutely love it, but there's just something about the white chocolate one that I just like a little bit more. I mean, to be honest, the two of them together really do actually make a complete palette, as you can see. I would pick up both of them because they do work very cohesively. They're both fantastic formula-wise. They are so good. If you haven't tried Hip Dot before, I definitely suggest checking them out. Let's move on to the next eyeshadow palette, the ColourPop Limoncello palette. This is arguably one of my favorite ColourPop palettes of all time. First off, the pan size is a little bit larger than their typical palettes. It does have this really gorgeous mirror. I know some people are like, how can a mirror be gorgeous? It's a freaking mirror. But trust me, I've had some palettes with some pretty shitty quality mirrors on the inside, and the mirror quality in here is top notch. This palette also has a little bit more weight to it, so it definitely feels a little bit more high end, a little bit more luxurious. The package design is gorgeous. I just love the vibe. I love the blue, the yellow, the greens, and the colors on the inside don't disappoint. They just totally embody the theme of this palette. This formula is beautiful. I am a huge fan of ColourPop. I've been a huge fan of them really since the beginning. I've been using their products for several years, and I have really yet to be truly full on overwhelmingly disappointed with a product. Obviously, they've released some things that I don't necessarily love, but overall, it's a very consistent brand for me. Their shadows are very consistent in formula, but I just love the color story of this palette. I love the pop of blue. This green shade right here is absolutely gorgeous. You just have everything you need to create a beautiful summer, neutral, or bright, fun look. It's really beautiful. Again, like I said, it's one of ColourPop's best palettes, at least one of the best palettes they have released in some time. Now let's move on to one of the biggest fails in this entire collection of products that I have in front of me. I'm embarrassed to even say this. I think it was around $65 for these three eyeshadows, and I totally got sucked into the packaging. I'll be honest with you. This is from Dior, and I'm looking over here at the packaging because I don't even know how to pronounce this. It's the Three Couleurs Trio Bleak Pure Glow. I don't even know if I'm saying that right, but it's basically an eyeshadow trio. This is in the shade 643 Pure Petals. I had such high hopes for this. I've never really tried any beauty products from Dior. First off, I can't even believe that they include these in here with a freaking 60 some dollar palette. Like, are you joking me? I'm not totally against sponge tip applicators because these can actually work quite well with metallic shades. But I mean, this little brush right here, these brushes, like, are you kidding me? Absolutely not. That's just, it's so tacky to me. I would have rather had them just leave it out or put one really nice brush in there, like what you get with like the Urban Decay Naked palettes. But look at this. I mean, this is really cute. I loved the embossing on the shadows themselves. I mean, it is truly beautiful, but this swatched is the biggest abomination of all time, especially for the price. And it really doesn't look much better on the eyes either. When I tried this, I was like, is this a joke? Why is it so hard pressed? I paid so much money for this, I expected at least mediocre payoff. No, it's honestly one of the most disappointing eyeshadows I have ever tried. Steer so clear of this. I should have returned this. I just never did. This is honestly probably the biggest waste of money of all time that I've ever spent on a beauty product. I mean, at least they included this cute little velvet little envelope here that you can store your shitty palette in. Maybe that's supposed to make you feel better about the fact that you just spent 60 some dollars on a palette that is just complete dog shit. Maybe that's the thing. I don't know what their angle is with that, but oh my goodness, I don't know. Maybe Dior should just not mess with makeup too much. Like I said, I haven't tried a lot of their products, so don't come for me if you've tried some products that are just absolutely fantastic, have blown your mind. That might be the case, but those are just, no, I want to burn it. It's really bad. There's no point in me even holding on to it. I do have another item from ColourPop. They recently released their cheek quads, and these are amazing. I have this on right now. These are beautiful. I love cheek palettes. I have grown to love them. They're some of my favorite things to have in my collection. Contour palettes, blush palettes, I love them. I can't get enough. The formula is fantastic. I absolutely love the highlighter in here. It's just like their Super Shock formula, so it's kind of got like that squishy, bouncy texture, but the payoff is just gorgeous. Why not? Let's tap some on the skin. Like, look at that. So beautiful. The Super Shock highlighters are some of my favorite formula. I absolutely love them, but the blushes in here do not disappoint at all. They blend beautifully. They look gorgeous on the skin. They're very long wearing, and they do have several different colorways to choose from. One of ColourPop's best items. I do have to say that. One of the best things they've launched in a while. Let's move on to another product that just disappointed me. This actually really truly broke my heart. So Jaclyn Cosmetics recently launched her liquid lipsticks. I wanted the lip liner, pictures, but they literally sold out in like less than a minute. I was so pissed off. The way that she talked up those damn lip liners, I was ready for some Jaclyn Cosmetics lip liners in my life. Now, I know she has since restocked, but to be honest with you, maybe it was for the better that I tried this first, because I did not like this formula at all. This reminded me of a mix of the Kylie Matte Liquid Lipsticks and the ColourPop Ultra Matte Liquid Lipsticks. If you took the two together and combined them, this is kind of what I feel like you would get. This formula is so incredibly drying, at least for me. I feel like it exaggerated every line in my lips. I just did not love this. And now I'm really hesitant to spend my money on the lip liners. I mean, they're like 18 bucks a piece. Let me know in the comments if you've tried the lip liners, but this just disappointed me. I was actually hoping, call me crazy, that she was going to relaunch her bullet lipsticks, because despite the issues with those, I actually picked up a few of those. The colors were beautiful. I actually wore one on my wedding day, and mine at first didn't have any lumps or bumps in it, so I didn't see an issue. But the more I used them, then I started getting the hard little balls in there, and it started to smell a little weird, like maybe the formula was old. You know when a lipstick starts to break down a bit? But those colors were so perfect. She nailed it. And without the issues, the formula was actually really good. I am bummed that she released liquid lipsticks. I kind of feel like the whole liquid lip thing has kind of been done. Like, are we over this trend? Not to say that there isn't good ones out there, but I feel like for a new brand to actually release a liquid lipstick, I was positive about it at first, and I was like, hey, maybe the formula is really good. If the formula is A+, I'll get a liquid lipstick. I don't care. But it ended up being not different than really any other one that I've tried. I just feel like I am just so much more of a fan of a regular traditional bullet lipstick or just a lip liner with some gloss on top. I'm really sad that this didn't work because the packaging is beautiful. And the two shades I picked up, I should tell you, were Oh Hi and Get Real. And both of them are kind of pretty warm toned. They really lean warm. And I was hoping they would be more neutral. That's what I liked about her bullet lipstick. So enough about those. Put them to the side. They just really aren't that good. So moving on. Let's talk about a mascara. So Wet n Wild released their Big Papa mascara. This shocked me, to be totally honest with you. I was blown away at how good this mascara is. This works just as good as some of the high-end mascaras that I absolutely love. I want to say this is under $5 or maybe around the $5 price tag, but the formula is so good. This gave me the most fluffy, big, lengthened, just gorgeous bombshell lashes of all time. I love this formula, and it was super long wearing as well. If you are looking for a new mascara to try and you don't want to break the bank, check this one out, because this is like Wet n Wild's best product. It's so good. Bouncing back to lipsticks for a moment, but NYX just launched, or I should say, I don't know if this is a relaunch or if this is a reformulation. This is their Lip Lingerie XXL, and I have to say, this formula blew me away. This is one of the most comfortable liquid lipsticks I have ever tried. This formula feels nourishing, it feels hydrating, but it is completely transfer proof. I have tested it for myself. It's really good. They actually sent these over to me. They sent me several shades, but my two favorites are Flaunt It and Stripped Down. These two neutral shades right here. I do believe it comes in 24 different shades. It's supposed to offer 16 hours of wear. No, this is not sponsored, by the way. They didn't pay me to talk about this right now, just so you know. I just really actually liked the formula. And with wearing masks and everything, if you want something that doesn't transfer, is less than $9, comes in a ton of different shades, is comfortable, and is going to be friendly to lips of any age, then this is definitely a formula that you need to check out. This is so, so good. I love it. Arguably my new favorite liquid lipstick, if I were to have a favorite. Shiseido launched a radiant version of their Synchro Skin Foundation. I am a huge fan of the original formula. It looks beautiful on my skin, but I am a sucker for a more radiant, hydrated finish, and this did not disappoint. It is still oil-free. It still offers an SPF of 30, but it is definitely more of a hydrating finish. Definitely full coverage. Does feel very flexible and weightless on the skin. One thing I love about Shiseido is their color options. This shade matches me perfectly. This is the shade 250 Sand, but is the foundation I do have on right now. I absolutely love it. Super long wearing, really comfortable on the skin, doesn't feel tacky, offers a gorgeous finish. It just looks beautiful. Totally worth the price tag. I love that stuff. I do have a couple items from Tarte. One is a major yes, and one is really a major no. Let's start with the major yes, and that is the Breezy Cream Blush, and this is in the shade Peach Sunset. This is my favorite cream blush right now. For a long time, the Rare Beauty Nearly Apricot Melting Blush, this one right here that looks like a Polly Pocket, so cute. Still love this. But this formula right now is really my current favorite. This is beautiful on the skin. It is not overly pigmented. It blends extremely well. It is really, really good. So check these out if you haven't already. Now the fail is this Lid Laugh Love Happiness Amazonian Clay Eyeshadow Wardrobe. This actually surprised me because I have tried so many of the Tarte wardrobe style products and I have loved them, but this just did not do it for me. Oddly enough, I wore this in a couple of TikToks and people were like, oh my God, what's on your eyes? It looks so pretty. And I'm thinking like, what? Really? Like, the finished look wasn't horrible. And I will say the mattes in here are really nice. The matte shades are nice. I like the mattes, but it's the metallics that really fell short. They're kind of powdery and chalky, and they just don't really give like that intense reflect. Now, if you like something a little bit more muted, then you'll love this. But for me, it was very disappointing compared to the other shadows that I have tried from Tarte. It just feels very dry. The metallics feel dry, which is unusual. Usually it's matte shadows that can feel dry and not metallic shades. I'm really sad because I think the packaging is so stinking cute. I love how compact this is and I like how huge it is. It's very cute, but I just don't love the formula. I was really, really sad about that. Let's move on to an item that I love. Love, love, love. I am very picky about body lotions. In fact, I'm one of those psychos that rarely applies body lotion. I will suffer through winter with itchy, dry skin because I actually don't like the way lotion feels on my skin at all. But this right here from Sol Janeiro, this is their Boom Dia Bright Cream. This smells incredible. Oh my gosh, does it smell so good? It is my favorite scent. I was just talking to my friend about this the other day, my best friend, I should say. And I was like, I'm really picky about scents. I don't own many perfumes at all. And it takes a lot for me to love a product and just want to slather it and smell like it all day. But this one did that to me. They're going to release the body mist and I'm like, I need to have it because it smells so freaking good. But besides the scent, the texture of this is so good. It is extremely hydrating, but does not feel heavy at all. Like, it sinks into my skin completely. And if I put this on at night, when I wake up the next day, I feel so smooth and soft, and the texture of my skin feels really good as well. Now, there is fruit AHAs in this, which is supposed to help with like KP, like those bumps that you get on your arm. I actually do get those bumps pretty badly, so the jury is still out if this actually helps with that. I'm not gonna hold anything against it if it doesn't, because like I said, I have a pretty intense case of that on my arms and my legs and such, but it does really leave my skin feeling very soft and plump and supple. I have to say that I might even like this formula better than the original Boom Boom Cream, and I think I might even like the scent more. Oh, it's divine. It's delicious, and it really does last all day. Like, I put this on at night. I smell like it for like the entire next day. It's fantastic. I did purchase the smaller size. I am almost out of it. Like, I have like barely any left in here, and I fully intend on buying the big one because this is my new favorite body lotion. I can't stop using it. So good. The last product I want to talk about is from Laura Lee Los Angeles. This is her new blender. I have never had a blender come clean as easily as this one. I don't know what the magic is in this, but I put a little bit of the Beauty Blender brand liquid sponge cleanser on this. With barely any effort, I like rub it like this, and all of the makeup comes out of it. Amazing. And it's super easy to clean. Like, that's the best part, is that I'm not spending a crap ton of time trying to get this damn thing clean. Like, it just comes clean. I also love the shape of this sponge. It's so unique and it's just the perfect texture. I love using this for my makeup. I haven't used anything else in several weeks. I blend my contour, my concealer, my foundation, all of my liquid products with this. Again, the shape of it is just really awesome because it fits perfectly. And I like that it's got the angle on one end. It's really good. I want to say this is like $13 or something like that. Really awesome price for what you're getting. It's high quality and I absolutely love it. Comment down below if you have tried any of these products and if anything I've mentioned has become your holy grail. Did you like the Jaclyn lipsticks? I would love to hear from you if you actually picked them up. Give this video a huge thumbs up if you enjoyed it so I continue to know to make videos like this one. I know I did say that I was going to touch quickly on where I've been and what's going on. In a nutshell, I've just been extremely depressed. I've been going through a major kind of like life crisis thing right now, I would say. I've been dealing with extreme anxiety, hypochondria, depression, back issues. I've had some personal conflicts with just things going on with family and my career and a lot of my own insecurities, and things just built up over time and really started to drag me down. I did make a community post about this, so go check it out if you want to read a little bit more, if you're interested. But I do want to say a massive thank you to those who commented and left me really kind words. Honestly, you are the reason that I am making this video right now. I could go into a lot of different things. I have tried to film a Get Ready With Me style video talking about this, but I end up just hating the content, which should tell you something. I've been really hard on myself lately and very, very critical. And there's been a lot of negative self-talk going on, and I'm just really trying to get through that. As far as where this channel is going, you know, it's up in the air. I want to be consistent. I do want to upload more, but I need to love what I'm uploading. That's the thing. I've always told myself, you know, if you take on an endeavor and it stops being fun, then that's when it's time to reevaluate and figure out if you want to continue. And that's kind of where I'm at right now. So I'm just trying to rebrand a bit. I love doing product reviews. It's my wheelhouse. It's really what brought my channel to where it is today. But I noticed that there's a change. I don't think people are watching product reviews as much. I do think that there are people who watch them. I just don't think they are what they once were. And I love them and I have fun doing them and I'm never going to stop. But I don't want it to be the only thing that I'm uploading to this channel. I want to have different dimensions and different things that we talk about here. So any suggestions that you have, comment down below. I do want to develop an upload schedule. I've been saying this for quite some time now, but I think it definitely needs to be a thing where I know that I have set days that I upload so that I do have some organization. I think that that's a huge issue too, that I don't have organization. I need to start writing down ideas I have and start doing what I need to do to kind of bring them to fruition and so that I can bring them to this channel. So just a quick update on where everything is. If you made it to the very end of this video, comment your favorite emoji down below, or if you're on a computer or something, leave me a smiley face. I like to hear from you guys. If you haven't already, I would love it if you would hit the subscribe button and return for more. I love you guys so much, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye, guys.